45 will be different from the first 45 we saw. Driving perfectly by Achire. Now Shamir, long stretch. Away by Okau. Baden. Two against one. Nunda loses that fight. Nunda does well. Shamir Kimwero. Achire. Trying to net that ball away to Okocha. It's long driven by Okocha. Very heavy towards. The cutback by Data is awaiting. Data here. It's Data! Crossback! Oh, ho, ho. What a finish! Alan Mugalu! Glorious that is! Alan Mugalu scoring his second goal of the season. The Maroons. Long cross from Okocha. And look at this from Data. He keeps the ball in play perfectly well. And looks up. And does deliver the simple tap. Alan Mugalu. Wonderful finish from him. Well, the former Arua Hill footballer scores his second goal in the Star Times Uganda Premier League. And the assist coming in from Data Joseph.
The first half has not really worked out as well as they probably had hoped it would.
Well, into the box area. Player brought down and the referee, Ronald Madanda, points to the spot. Interesting. Amos Kiria once again turns provider. Took a bit of a moment there for the referee to make his decision. Straight to the back of the net. First class penalty, top notch. He rarely makes a meal of them in that particular area. Very prime, absolutely splendid there from Benson Muhindo. In a game where both teams have been quite regular at their style of play, one split second moment allows Gaddafi to take the lead just before halftime.
Well, I guess that they couldn't have asked for anything better than that. And for them to have got that penalty and taking a lead going into the halftime gives them a very good head start going into the second half.
Let's see. Probably could have been on, but that was not a foul in my view. I don't think it was.
Well, very slim
margins.
Because
he got the ball, yeah.
Very slim margins and the penalty well executed. Goalkeeper guessing the right way, but Mohindo's precision and power putting it well beyond his reach.
Yeah, I thought that the take was very good, Mohindo. He's got that real good way of take. Needed to do, and they did exactly what they needed to do at that point. After they've gone down to a goal, and you feel that maybe there's a bit of injustice, then you respond in the kind of manner that they have done, and that is very good play coming in from Mbara. But that was very poor defending coming in now from Gaddafi Football Club. How does that pass? Nobody's pressing the ball. Just look at Otong, and then he watches, and then the marking. It is clearly wretched there. Very easy goal for Joseph Akwananaho not to be considered at this level of the game.
It's often said momentum swings from the team that has just scored, and in that instance, nothing could be truer. Joseph Akwananaho utilizing the moment and quickly snatching a comeback. Nothing could be truer. Joseph Akwananaho utilizing the moment and quickly snatching a comeback for his team. Now he's quick to put the ball into touch. Akwananaho spreading out on the wing. Can he pick out a cross? Opts to try and dribble past his fellow captain. Second attempt, second failure.
Yeah. I guess Ibrahim Chiemba has come into this game with a lot of determination to ensure that he stops Akwananaho because of the threat that he poses. He's supposed to be a key man for Mbara.
Spaced in. Munguchi leaves his mark on the ground. Settled in! He's barely been on for 3 minutes. Joshua Amiru Kaka completes a brilliant move. Now that was all the superlatives that he deserves.